Next topic is principle of a capacitor. Okay. Now, first of all, consider one conductor. Okay. You are giving the charge Q. Here, it holding charge is only Q. Okay. And also potential V. So, if in case you are giving the additional charge, it doesn't, it's not taken. Like 1 liter water bottle. Okay. In 1 liter water bottle, it takes only 1 liter of water. Okay, it not taken more than 1 liter. Like here, conductor. Initially, charge on this one is, that means its capacity is up to Q only. Okay, further, it does not taken. So, to taken more charge, okay, to taken more charge, required condition is to increasing the size of this capacitor. To increasing the size of this capacitor. Are understood? To increasing the size of this capacitor. Okay. So without changing of its dimensions, without changing of its dimensions, how to increase its capacitance? How to increase its capacitance? How to increase its capacitance? Okay. So one process is there. Okay. You know, C is equal to Q by V. If in case potential is decreases, what about its capacitance? Increase. Its capacitance is increase. Understood? Okay. Further purpose. First of all, it is a charged conductor. Its capacitance is Q and potential is V. C is equal to Q by V. You know this one. Plate A. Okay, nearer to this charged conductor, place nearer to the charged conductor, place the another uncharged conductor. Another uncharged conductor. So, it is uncharged means induced charge is developed on this one equal in magnitude, but opposite in nature. Nearer side is negative. Another side is positive. Nearer side is negative. Another side is positive. Are understood? Okay. Due to this negative charge, its potential is decreases. Due to this positive charge, its potential is increases. Understood? So, it is nearer to this one. Decreasing potential is more compared to the increasing potential. Are you understood or not? Once again, here one uncharged conductor is placed nearer to the charged conductor. Induced charge is developed on the uncharged conductor. Nearer side is opposite charge. Okay. Another side is same charge. Due to opposite charge, its potential is decreased. Due to like charge, potential is increased. It is nearer to this one. That's why decreasing is more. Understood? Okay. In another process, if in case it is grounded, means this side completely neutralized. This side in outside is completely neutralized. Okay. Okay. Due to this negative charge, what about its potential? Decreases. If potential is decreased means, what about its capacitance? Increase. Its capacitance is increase. Okay. So, this is the principle of a capacitor. Okay. To increase the capacitance of a conductor. Okay. To increase the capacitance of a conductor, bring the uncharged conductor nearer to this charged conductor and another side is earthening. Okay. Due to this process, its capacitance is increases. So, it is the principle of a capacitor. It is the principle of a capacitor. Understood? Okay. So, here earthening is not important. Okay. Not necessary. But main important one is, here, charge on the conductor is equal in magnitude but opposite in nature. Opposite in nature. That is the most important one. Understood? Okay. See,
capacitance of a spherical conductor.
Okay. So to concentric spheres, so charge is here plus Q. Okay, induced charge is minus Q. Outer side is connected to the ground. Inner radius is A. Outer sphere radius is B. So capacitance of this one is C is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught AB by B minus A. Okay. Capacitance of a cylindrical capacitor. Okay. Here, inner cylinder radius is A. Outer one is B. Now, outer one is connected to the ground. Length is L. Its capacitance is 2 pi epsilon naught L by log base C B by A. Understood. Okay. No need of derivation for this one.